Thank you so much for agreeing to do this. We have absolutely enraptured audience overall. They want to decode this enigma called Vicky Kaushal. It seems like a mysterious and yet such a draw that you have for especially the youngsters. It's something absolutely breathtaking. So the theme of the event is the stories we tell also tell us. So we want to know your story. Was it an unlikely one? I mean, could you take us back to your days of engineering and then how you journeyed, how it all started off? Because I know that it all started with an industrial event, if I'm not wrong. A lightning struck.
I would actually like to take the story a little further back.
Oh, lovely.
For 2 years of my life, I have stood at the bus stop right here. I was a Mitibai student. For 2 years of my life, I have stood at this bus stop. I was a science student, so my classes used to be from 7:30 to 1 o'clock in the afternoon. And I used to stand at the bus stop over here, wait for 79, 33, 38. These are the three buses that used to take me home. And I want to know, how much does the vada pav cost over here now? 30? 20? So when I was doing my junior college in Mitibai, this was 2001 to 2003.
By the way, when was the last time you had a vada pav?
Vada pav? I keep having vada pav on set. Yeah. I call for vada pavs. But in 2001 to 2003, I was in Mitibai. And that time, the vada pav used to be of 5 rupees. 5 rupees. When I went to 12th, it was 6 rupees because I used to put Amul butter. And I remember those days, I used to be given pocket money by my parents, and my pocket money was 600 rupees a month, which was 20 rupees a day.
Right.
So from Lokhandwala to here, 5 rupees busky ticket, 5 rupees busky ticket, 10 rupees, 5 rupees vada pav, and 5 rupees I used to save. So that 2 weeks baad Chandan mein picture lagni hai. Ya phir picture nahi dekhni hai to har dusre din fir main ek energy peeta tha. Energy milti hai abhi bhi. Energy I used to love. So I've started from here,
right.
And then of course I did my engineering from Rajiv Gandhi Institute of Technology. Till that time, I'm still that guy, but I've always believed in living in the present, going with the flow, and just being completely honest to what I'm doing now. Yeah, jo bhi mazay karne mazay karta tha. That's it. कोई अगर पूछता था क्या करना है तो सब MBA कह रहे हैं तो मैं भी MBA कह देता था. जब सब ने GRE कहना शुरू कर दिया मैं भी GRE कहने लग गया. तो द प्लान वाज टू डू पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन, फिर देखते हैं कहाँ जाती है जिंदगी. एंड आई वाज गुड इन स्टडीज बट आई वाज वेरी एक्टिव ऑन स्टेज सिंस चाइल्डहुड, बट ओनली सबकॉन्शियसली आई लव डूइंग दैट. बट तब तक मुझे लगता था इट्स जस्ट एन हॉबी, कि मुझे अच्छा लगता है बीइंग ऑन स्टेज परफॉर्मिंग फॉर एन ऑडियंस, बट नेवर रियली थॉट दैट आई वांट टू मेक इट अ करियर चॉइस. So when I was doing my engineering in the second year, the college faculty took us to an industrial visit to show us ki bachcho, this is your future. You know, when you pass out, from you complete your graduation, this is how an MNC looks, this is how the work, whatever, the floor looks and how people work. And that was that one day that I felt something so purely in my life for the first time, that my andar ghusa, I'm like, this is not for me.
Exactly
not for me. Main pahunch jaunga. Academics is supporting, the way I'm functioning in my exams, it's supporting. Main pahunch jaunga, but I can't connect. This is not me. And that was the first time I thought, Vicky, what now? What do you want to do? Because there's no point doing post-graduation in the same field if you don't want to eventually come to this chair. So that was the first time I started introspecting as to what do you want to do. So I was thinking, achha, yahan mujhe nahi jana because this is something that I feel I won't enjoy, I won't be happy doing, I won't be self-motivated to do. Then what is it that I really enjoy doing? So the answer was performing for the audience. And that was the first time I thought, ki yaar, actor? And I still remember that moment when I was looking into the mirror and I said... And then I looked at myself from top to bottom and I'm like... And then I'm like, but choice nahi hai. And I'm like, chal dekhte hain. And then, but the thing was, the rule was in the family that first you have to finish graduation. You have to finish it well.
And engineering.
Aur ab to ghus chuke
the, there's a joke about engineering. Like, it's like a public toilet. No offense to the engineers.
Public what?
public toilet, because when you're out, you're dying to get in, but when you're in, you're dying to get out.
ऐसा नहीं है.
That's like you. Even I'm an engineering dropout. So.
Actually, to be honest, I really had a ball of a time doing engineering.
Oh.
Yeah. कल को मेरे बच्चे पता नहीं क्या करेंगे, पर मैं engineering में जरूर डालूँगा. Because I have found the best of my friends over there, and मैं तब तक ना till my engineering, I was a very shy, coy boy, जो मतलब he was not street smart, he was just बेचारा. Engineering ने जो मेरे अंदर का मर्द जगाया है, क्योंकि engineering में तो it's like it teaches you the, all that scrutiny and assignments and projects and all of that teaches you a lot more than just education. It really teaches you the grind. So I had a blast doing my engineering. I finished that, and then in 2009 is when I started my journey as an actor.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's how it all began. As audience, we always like to look at the glory days of an actor, of how he's doing well and all the success and fanfare that he's enjoying. But failures is something that we don't talk about. Like the everyone has a good share of it. Was it a straightforward journey? Because if I'm not wrong, you start off with assisting Anurag and then.
It started in 2009, where my first step towards this profession of acting was that I wanted to be really sure that it's more than a hobby.
Okay.
That every day when I wake up in the morning, I really want to act. Mm-hmm. That's all that I want to do after waking up in the morning. So I joined an acting institute in Bombay. This was a 6-month program where, of course, I wanted to learn acting. Of course, I wanted to learn the skills. But more than that, I just wanted to be sure that if I'm made to act every day, am I a happier soul or am I cribbing about it? That's what I really wanted to know. So I did that, and by the end of it, I got my answer that I really, really love doing this. After that, I was also sure, I remember I was 22 back then, right after engineering, I was 22. I was in no hurry to be in front of the camera.
Right.
Because I knew that, firstly, camera captures everything. You're a good actor, bad actor, fantastic actor, worst actor. It will present you the way you are, because in acting, your eyes have to be honest, and the camera captures everything. The audience, in 2 seconds, of sitting in that cinema hall, in that first shot you give, in that first scene that you do, they know that if you can act or not. And once they've made that judgment that then it's a very uphill task to really prove your worth to the audience. So I wanted to do all of that before actually coming to the audience. So I had kept 5 years in my mind that kam se kam main 5 saal dunga to study this, to learn the tropes, to meet people, learn from them, assist them, do backstage in theatre, do everything that is related to cinema and acting, learn all that I can before I'm fairly even confident to face the camera and come in front of the audience. So it's very strange, because when I was doing that acting course in 2009, I still remember the date was 24th of July 2009, and it was the first day of my acting course, and the teacher, it was a class of 20 students, and they just randomly asked, like, you know, okay, how have your last five years been like? And we were all discussing that, and then they asked that, how do you want your next 5 years to be like, and where do you see yourself in the next 5 years? And I really am not a big fan of this question, because I don't know what I'm going to do in the next 5 minutes, and I really don't want to know where I'm going to be. Sometimes where you think you're going to be in the next 5 years is much smaller than what God has planned for you. So I don't want to limit myself in that thought process. But still, but I was asked that question, and just because it was the first day of the class, and I didn't want to say that I don't like that question, because I thought that they might just throw me out of the school. So I just answered that, sir, 5 saal lagenge ya 6 saal lagenge, you'll see my poster in front of a cinema. I just said that with all belief, ki 5-6 saal lagenge, I'll do theater, I'll assist somebody, I'll do behind the scene work, and I'll be there. This was 24 July 2009, and 24th July 2015 was the day when Masaan released, and my poster was there. Sometimes things like these make me believe in belief. like believe in belief that, you know, ki you just have to sometimes just give it out there. Just give it out and do it. Like, you know, sometimes it's not necessary for you to know how it's going to happen, but it's very necessary for you to believe that it's going to happen. If you believe that it's going to happen is when the how takes care of itself. So, I mean, you guys are going to start and do whatever you want to do in life, but never, never lose that belief. That's step one. Before skill, before talent, before everything else, that's step one.
Great. That's
and I also want to give a disclaimer that I tend to forget my questions and I go on a different trip. So just get me back whenever you feel that.
We're going to do the failure part. Which
failure.
Failure ki to baat hi nahi ki pravachan dene lag gaya.
Failure, yes. I saw.
That is very important because when you look at the youngsters,
of course,
they are very bad at accepting rejection. And failure is something that rattles them.
Yeah.
So I think it's equally important.
और फिर बाद में एक लिस्ट दी जाती है कि आप अपना नाम लिखो, नंबर लिखो, और फिर वो लिस्ट में जब आपका नंबर आएगा तब आपको अंदर बुलाया जाएगा. फिर एक डेढ़ घंटा वेट करने के बाद आपको अंदर बुलाया जाता है. फिर आप देखते हो कि 200 और ग्लैडराइज के मॉडल अंदर है. और फिर एक कैमरा होता है, एक कास्टिंग डायरेक्टर होता है, एंड देन ही और एक स्क्रिप्ट दी जाती है आपको कि ये फलाना फलाना 5-10 लाइन बोलने, एंड यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर देयर देन एंड देयर कि आप प्रिपेयर कीजिए और वहाँ पे आप बोलिए. और व्हाइल यू आर वेटिंग ऑल दोस 100 पीपल आर डूइंग देयर परफॉर्मेंसेस एंड वहां बैठे बैठे यू रियलाइज सो मच कि वेयर यू स्टैंड बिकॉज सम कम which really raise your confidence because you're like, this is the better you want. And some come which you are like, yeah, main nikalta hu yahan to nahi hoga, ye kya tha, isne to mujhe rula diya. So every day, so that giving 8 to 10 auditions every day and going through this process really, like, you know, आपको अपना लेवल बता देता है. एंड समटाइम्स व्हाट हैपेंस इज मैं एड्स के ऑडिशंस बहुत देता था, फिल्म्स के भी, बट समटाइम्स यू गेट सिलेक्टेड इन द टॉप 3. देन यू लाइक यस. फिर आपको फोन आता है कि सर आपका बजट क्या है, आप टॉप 3 में आ चुके हो, कल पीपीएम है हमारी, फिर डायरेक्टर्स प्रोड्यूसर्स के साथ बात होगी, फिर हम सिलेक्ट करेंगे. देन यू गिव योर बजट एंड देन यू वेटिंग फॉर दैट कॉल एंड देन वो कॉल करके बताते हैं कि सर आप सिलेक्ट नहीं हुए. लेकर यार एंड देन यू गिव ऑडिशंस एंड देन यू सिलेक्ट गेट सिलेक्टेड अगेन. फिर नहीं होता. फिर मुझे लगा शायद यार बजट की वजह से तो नहीं हो रहा कि देन फिर मैं सिलेक्ट होने लग गया. फिर वो कहता कि सर आप बजट बताओ. मैंने कहा सर आप बजट बताओ, आप बताओ, मैं उसमें भी रेडी हूँ, आप मुझे काम दो आप. फिर उसमें भी नहीं होने लग गया तो एटलीस्ट मुझे लगा बजट की वजह से नहीं है, जो भी क्राइटेरियाज है. बट द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज टू जस्ट कीप गोइंग, यू नो, टू जस्ट कीप गोइंग. आई हैव ओनली टिल अबाउट उरी एंड मनमर्जिया हैव बीन द ओनली टू फिल्म्स दैट आई हैव नॉट गिवन अ स्क्रीन टेस्ट फॉर. आई जस्ट गॉट picked up by the director ki nahi tu hi karega ye role. Otherwise every other film, be it Razi, Sanju, Masan, Raman Raghav, La Pasco Effort, Zuban, my first break, every other film I got it through a screen test. So these are, I could count the number of films on my fingers, but I have given at least 1000 to 2000 to 3000 auditions. I have given at least those auditions. And then out of them, I have got 8 films. So the failure rate is much higher, much, much higher. But the important thing is to just keep walking, just keep walking, just keep walking, just keep walking. Just keep walking. Yeah.
Once you did Masan, you were noticed, and then you went on to other films. But which film was exactly the turning point you thought that this has really made my presence and...
Uri!
Much later, right? Even before that, you thought there was a...
Sanju!
Do you agree? I think I should answer.
Sanju!
As an actor, it's the most beautiful feeling when you as an audience I'm naming so many films as my turning point. It's the most beautiful thing. But Masan was the first film that came out. See, Zuban, actually the film that came out after that, which not many people came to know of it, but that was the first audition for the lead role that I had cracked and the first film that I had shot for. And then I shot for Masan, but Masan came out first. But Masan was the first work that people saw of mine, and it really gave me a lot of credibility because the film got a lot of credibility. It opened a lot of doors in the industry for me. Mm-hmm. But after Masaan, for the longest time, I was, "Arey, woh Masaan ka hero. Arey, that Masaan guy." But the past 1 year with films like Razi, Sanju, Manmarzi, and then of course Uri just changed everything for me. But then, पिछले एक साल से विकी कौशल ज़्यादा सुनाई देता है. That you know they know my name. But all these films in some way or the other have turned something in my life for the good.
Right, great. You also mentioned Raman Raghav. Now that is a very under-celebrated yet a very powerful film that a lot of people really admire. Especially the character that you played was intense and had shades of. Was there a particular process or with respect to preparation that you went through? Because we got to know that you sort of tried to isolate yourself and tried a lot to get into the character. So, what kind of acting you subscribe to? Do you believe in that? That there is something called as a classical acting style, there is method acting, or do you think it's just these distinctions don't really.
I don't really believe in one approach towards acting, because I feel at the end of the day, between action and cut, I have to be honest.
Correct.
That route could be anything.
Right.
Anything.
Right.
मैं चाहे एक दिन पहले कितना भी Stanislavski पढ़ लूँ, but between action and cut, if I'm not feeling it, I'm not feeling it.
Correct.
You know. So my goal is to reach that honestly. No matter how I reach that, different films, different characters, depending on how far or near that character is to you, you decide on your route. That अच्छा what you need to do. अच्छा इसमें मुझे ये करना है. So like the example you picked up, Raman Raghav, that character was really far away from me, really far right. away in terms of emotions. Mm-hmm. Like Masaan was geographically very far away. कि मुझे लहजा नहीं आता, वो कैसे बात करते हैं, वहाँ के वो जो डोम कम्युनिटी है, जो वो काम करती है, उनका क्या तौर तरीका होता है, तो मुझे वो अडैप्ट करना था. But for Raman Raghav, I had to adapt the emotional state of mind, which was very difficult for me. So when Anurag sir had called me up that you know कि मैं ऐसे एक फिल्म बना रहा हूँ serial killer और cop पे. I wanted to play the cop, but I don't think you can really play him because he's a very edgy, disturbed character, and he knows my family, he knows my upbringing, and he's like, you've had a very secure upbringing, so I don't know if you're gonna be able to understand that. I was like, sir, let me give a screen test, let's see. I don't know what your film is all about, but let me just give a screen test. It'll be at least a good exercise for me as an actor to explore
right.
it. So for 5 days, I told him, he said, ki kitne din chahiye mujhe. Maine kaha mujhe 5 din de diye, and then I'll come to your office after 5 days. So I thought that if it's something so far away from me, let me try this tool of isolation. Let me physically separate myself from my friends and my family, from my comfort space. Let me live somewhere and just disconnect. So for 5 days, I was living in another house that I have, where there were no newspapers, no TV, no phone. I was not stepping out of the house. I was not communicating with anyone. 5 days, I've stayed quiet. Just not talk. So, and I used to step out only once in the day, which was at 4 a.m. Which was at 4 a.m. late in the night when the world outside is sleeping.
Correct.
So, and I wanted to know what's happening to me. If I'm becoming edgier, if I'm being irritated, if it reminds me of the darkness inside, past, whatever. I didn't know what's going to happen. So for first day, I was really bored. Second day, I was maha bored. Third day, I was like, I really need to talk to somebody. Fourth day, I started getting really irritated. Fifth day, I wanted to kill Anurag Kashyap. And then fifth day, after leaving from there, I straight went to Mukesh Chawla's office, who was the casting director. And I gave that screen test, and I was very happy. And I remember this was sometime around September, because after that, I had to go to my building where we keep Ded Din Ka Ganpati. So it was around Ganpati. So I was very happy. Hey, yaar, achanak se ab main 100 logon se milunga. I was very. Sabko gale lagane ka mandar hai. So I gave the audition and I got a call from Anurag sir that I've seen the audition, come back. I was like, acha. Then I went back and the first thing he said was, ki jo bhi tune kiya hai, jo bhi tune wo scene perform kiya hai, that's exactly what I don't want. And failure. And then I was like, okay, roll gaya. So, but then he's like, but I'm locking you for the part. And I'm like, huh? And then he's like, nee, I could see something in your eyes, but I'll take you there. I could see the character, but we'll have to do a process. But then there was a process and we did the film. And the process was, eventually when we started, the process was, it was just a 21-day shoot. 21 days straight we finished the film. Day in, day out, we were shooting. Most of them were nights. irritating scenes where he had to beat up women and do drugs and this and that. It was a very dark film. So I told my parents not to talk to me. I stay with my family. And usually what happens is whenever I come back from shoot, my mom, being mom, she's like, beta, kaisa raha shoot and this and that. Be it 4 a.m., 6 a.m., 10 p.m., whatever the time is, she'll sit with me and ask me about the day. So I asked her, ki, ye mat karna mere saath. I'm going to just quietly come, sleep, eat, go. 20 din, sirf, don't talk to me. That was there. And the other process was that I used to listen. Music sometimes helps you. So music was also a tool for me. I used to listen to a lot of Skrillex songs. I don't know. Okay. But Skrillex is a lot of like a trap music. And before giving the shot, I remember we were shooting in Anurag's house. So I was used to go into the bathroom and I used to put my headphones on and listen to some Skrillex songs. And I used to rage in the bathroom. I used to rage. Rage matlab, I used to rage. Like talk to myself, scream, rage and everything. And then come out and then do the scene. And then, I remember, and Anurag Kashyap, being Anurag Kashyap, he's got the tendency of giving you 4 pages ka scene, ki kal karte hai. And haan, kal karte hai. Ye 4 pages to bolega. And then, so there was a scene like that where I had to just talk to a camera. It got deleted from the film, then he put it on YouTube much later. So there's a deleted scene on YouTube if you want to check from Raman Raga, where it's just 6 minutes monologue, which I'm talking to a handicap. That's it. So that, and it's a scene where he's almost going to commit suicide. But he decides, he's got his angst against his father and he decides that let me just record it on a handicam first and then I'll shoot myself. So it was a very heavy scene. That I remember, I used to do the scene. I used to, coming back from the shoot, I used to step out from my building at about 2 o'clock, 2:30 in the night. And I used to take rounds, I used to walk on the streets and I used to just say those lines. I used to just say those lines, not emoted, nothing, because I didn't want to feel it much earlier on before doing that scene, because I don't think a moment like this where you feel suicidal, where you feel like almost coming, killing yourself, comes very often to you. So I didn't want to feel it every day. I wanted to feel it for the take, but I just wanted to be very fluent with the lines. So I would just take rounds and I would just talk. I would just say these lines. I would just say these lines for like 1 hour ka walk pe I'll go and then come back home and go to sleep. And then we did that scene. So there were like different methods and approaches. But the fun trivia about Raman Raghav is, and why I'll remember this film for the rest of my life is, because when the time came when the film was shown and there was a screening, and of course my family goes for every screening, they watch the film. This was one screening I was very scared. Because I'm not doing nice things in the film. Anurag Kashyap had shot me naked in the film. I'm doing drugs, I'm beating a woman. So I was very, and I told my mom, don't ask me anything. So my mom was very excited. Ki are are aaj picture dekhne ja rahe hain, bete ki picture dekhne ja rahe hain. I'm like, ma, aap jao, main dekh chuka hoon, aap jao. Because I couldn't sit next to her and watch that. Exactly. And so, are aise kaise, nahi nahi, chalna padega, chalna padega, chalo. So then we went and mom was sitting. And then I'm like, mom, main zara teen row peeche baithta hoon, main zara apne team ke saath baithta hoon. Haan, haan, beta. Movie starts, movie is going on, mom is watching the film, I am watching mom. And I am like, अब एक चप्पल ऐसे पीछे उड़ती हुई आने वाली है या फिर मॉम उठते ही निकल जाएंगे और मुझे डिसोन करने वाली है तो आई एम जस्ट वॉचिंग हर मेरा टेंशन खत्म कर दिया शी वाज हैविंग अ समोसा एंड शी इज लाइक आई एम लाइक मॉम कैसी लगे शी इज लाइक बकवास फिर तो सेकेंड हाफ तो मैंने इतना इंजॉय किया कि मैंने कहा ये तो अभी अलग ही मॉम कहीं और ही जा चुकी है मॉम तो पिक्चर देख ही नहीं रही है मैंने कहा आप जो मर्जी दिखा दो यार सब सही है
Wow, that sucks for me. So we ran a social media contest called as Wikipedia. And we gave the opportunity for everyone to ask questions. Of course, we couldn't take all of it because we got close to 1,580 questions. But we just shortlisted 8 questions from the 1,580 that we had. So I'm just going to read out the names, the lucky ones, and you can ask questions to Vicky. All right? That's how we're going to do it.
It can be more than 8 also. This is look at these beautiful faces. Wow.
So I hope the volunteers are ready with the mic. The first lucky contestant is Nawal Sheikh. Somebody hand over the mic.
Hi, Nawal.
Hi, Ricky. Oh my god, I don't know. So if I fumble in my question, just forgive me.
That's okay.
I know.
I'll fumble in the answer.
So my question to you is, in your entire career that we've seen, we've basically seen you in so many different kind of genres that you've chosen, from Raman Raghav to Masaan to Uri to Lust Stories, and every movie has a different character. So when you go through these scripts, what exactly are you looking for when you read the scripts? And especially now that you're doing both, and I've heard that you're scared of horror films. So what is the thing that you do when you look at the scripts, and how do you choose these scripts, basically?
So if I'm reading a script, firstly, I'm not reading as the actor who's being approached to play a part in the film. I read it as an audience, jisne 300 rupees ki ticket khareedi hai. And I read my scripts in one go. And mostly I do that late in the night, like from 12 to 3, 12 to 4 is my favorite time to read scripts. I read that in one go, so that by the end of the script, I want to get a sense of having watched a film, and then feeling if I liked it or not.
If I really enjoyed it. In your brain, basically.
Yeah, I kind of visualize in my head, try and do that. And see if I'm, as an audience who's paid for it, if I enjoyed this time or no. If I feel like after getting done with the script, if I feel like talking to my friends about it, ki are yaar ek bahut sahi kahani suni maine, yaar bahut ek sahi character hai. If I feel like talking about that or not. So that's the first tick that I look for. Secondly, the director, who the director is, because I feel cinema is a director's medium. The same script can be made into 100 different films by 100 different directors. It's their vision that matters a lot. I am just a medium to showcase his or her vision to the audience. So who the director is. Third is if I've done something like that in the past or no. If I'm repeating myself or not, I would not want to repeat myself because then that doesn't allow me to grow. So I'm looking for these three basic things. So if these three things are right, then I go for it. For Bhoot, I only had one thing. If I read it, because I felt that horror film is a very audiovisual experience. So it was the first time I was reading something horror. So I wanted to know if I'm feeling scared or not. If I'm really high. if I'm feeling scared by the end of the session. So I felt really scared. I was very, very scared. I just did that film. I hope that the audience is also scared when they watch the film.
Second contestant is Maitri Desai.
Oh, hi Maitri. Hi.
So I wanted to ask you that, as you know, we have a filmmaking course as well. So we as film students, we always look for, answers about what happens between takes.
Yeah.
So as all of us sitting here want to make the best out of this opportunity that we've got of meeting you, could you please give us an insight about what happens between takes on film sets?
It actually depends from film to film. Depends on the mood of the film, depends on who the director is, how his functioning is. I don't like to leave the set. Like me as an actor, and I can give you more insight as an actor more than a filmmaker because that's my forte. As an actor, I don't like to leave set between takes. Like I don't like to go to the van unless I feel like using the loo or something. But otherwise, I don't feel like leaving the set because that also is a very important character in the film. Like I like to spend time on set. If there is a room in the film which is my bedroom, the character's bedroom, I want to know each and every prop that is there in that room, why it's there, what is his connect to that prop. Because if I feel like improvising, if I feel like incorporating that in my scene, that thought is going to come from me and that is going to be my input as an actor. And that sometimes director is looking at the entire film. He's got 100 actors to look for. He's got editing, sound, everything going on. For me, it's my world. It's that character's world. So I need to know my world in the film. So between takes, sometimes it's just knowing. Sometimes for me as an actor, it's more of knowing the space. Most of the times, it's bonding with your co-actors. because depends again on how your relationship in the film is. Like me and Tapsee from Manmarziya, we would, like we were practically living together. Like it was almost like we were on set together the entire time, because that had to come across in the film, or be it me and Ranbir and Sanju. Our workshop for the film was for like 30 to 40 days before we started shooting. It was just me, Ranbir and Raju sir sitting at his office for hours at stretch and faffing. That's it. Faffing. Just faffing. Beech mein hum scenes bhi karte the, but it was just faffing, because the energy that we have while we faff, that is the energy that we wanted in the film between those two characters. Lines to hote hain. But it's always what is there between the lines is where performance comes. It is what the audience always remembers, what's between those lines. That those are the moments that ki wahan kya ho raha is what matters. You know, in real life, it's not what we speak that matters. It's what we not speak, what we hold back, is makes me Vicky, makes you who you are. So I need to know what I said as that part, and what are the things that I didn't say as that part, but which was there in my head. So you need to bond with your co-actors, need to know them, gel with them. So all of that is going on with your team, because at the end of the day, it's a team effort. You know, the set has to be a happy set. It has to be a nice, and people should enjoy working together. But technically, most of the times, like for an Anurag Kashyap film, Anurag sir is writing his scenes while being on set. So if you've seen Manmarziya, there's this last scene that my character had, where you know he finally accepts that he and Rumi can't be together. That scene, we were in costumes, and Raksha said ki track laga ke rakh, camera ready rakh. And then we have that picture also where he's sitting with his notepad writing the scene, and me and Tapsee like, hum ready hai, but director abhi likh rahe hai scene. So aise garam garam pakodon ki tarah kabhi kabhi line milta hai. And uske baad mein, जब हम सीन कर रहे हैं, सो द लास्ट मोमेंट इन द सीन इज दैट आई एक्सेप्टेड दैट यू नो अब ये लव स्टोरी आगे नहीं जा रही, एंड वी हग एंड इट्स ऑलमोस्ट लाइक टीरी आईड एंड इमोशनल एंड ये वो, एंड आई डोंट वांट टू लीव यू बट आई हैव टू लीव यू काइंड ऑफ मोमेंट, एंड द कैमरा इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी, अनुराग सर कम्स, ही डक्स नेक्स्ट टू द कैमरा, ही लुक्स एट मी, ही इज लाइक एंड आई हैव hug Tapsee doesn't know ki kya ho raha hai, and I look at him in full emo, and I gauge ki he's saying alag ho ja, and I just go alag. Tapsee is wondering ki ye kya hua, I'm wondering ki ab main kya karun, and director wants to see ki ab ye kya karenge, and we are like ki, and sometimes what happens is once the scripted scene gets over is when the actor actually starts thinking ki chama as character kya karega next. That's not written. So I am feeling awkward, she's feeling awkward, director is not saying cut. So till that time, it is my dharam to keep acting. So I start beatboxing, because I was feeling so awkward, I need to do something. I start beatboxing, which makes her smile, which makes me smile, and kind of removes that awkwardness. And that's when he says cut, because he wanted to see these two characters who have not felt awkward in the entire film feel awkward, and then see what they do. So sometimes these things come in between takes. So it's a wide world that what happens between takes. But yeah, sorry, it was a bit long answer, but
pretty much answered more than what she asked.
I agree.
Now, other than the students, we also have a bunch of excited faculty members, and they have some interesting questions. And I would like to put our principal on the hot seat.
Yes! I want to say, by the way, I want to say, your principal is gym buddy.
Gym buddy.
Is my gym buddy. She's outstanding.
Qualities, please. I'm sure she would want to ask something.
That's where she got me for the session, huh? I was like, Vicky UPG, I was like, Sorry, man. Your mic is not on.
The mic is...
Yeah. Is it on, the mic? No.
काफी डर गया मैं क्या पूछने वाली हूँ. Vicky, you're an outstanding human being, more than, I mean, as an actor, of course. Really, thank you for making this as a memorable moment for my students. That's why you're here today. And he's put me in a hot spot, but I will share with you that many students, I kept telling you that they kept telling me, ma'am, if you can get Vicky here, and I kept asking them, why do you want Vicky here? He's a youth icon. A lot of them said, he's so humble, he's such a simpleton, we identify with him. But you'll be surprised. Some of the girls asked me, rather told me that he's the kind of guy I would take to my mom. When they do decide to marry, because nowadays our girls don't want to get married so young, but so you're that kind of guy. Now I want to ask you, and I'm putting you in a little bit of a hot spot. I know you may not want to gym with me again after this. But what kind of a girl would you like to take home for mom?
I was expecting that question from you. What kind of a girl? पहले तो I just want to say that घर की situation अभी ऐसी है. Mom just wants me to get a girl home. Like a friend of mine who stays in Jersey, she's expecting a child now. And I was very scared to tell this to mom. Because mom is like, sharam kar le. Sharam kar le. Mujhse younger, mera ek mubala bhai hai, who's like an old friend of mine. Achanak se his dad broke the news. Keh rahe, uski sagai hai kal, aayega ghar. Maine kaha satyanash, maine kaha, tu kyun hamari band mein ja raha hai? My dad, I was going into a narration. And I'm getting 3 calls from my dad. He called to call Karizan, and I'm like, my narration, mein, and then finally take like a 2-minute break, and I'm like, I just need to call up dad because tension ho jata na. Mom, dad ne ek se upar call kiya, matlab tension ho. So maine phone kiya, and I'm like, dad, kya hua main narration ho? Like, kuch to sharam kar le, uski sagai ho rahi hai. So is filhal to they really want me to get settled. What kind of girl? I don't know. Pehli baat to jo jis ladki ko main pasand aa jaun, wo pehle. मैं ठीक हो जाऊं एंड देन दैट माय मॉम डजंट वांट दैट माय मॉम श्योरली डजंट वांट बट फॉर मी माय काइंड ऑफ गर्ल इज कि जहां मैं जिस लड़की के साथ इफ आई एम इन द सेम रूम एंड वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग एंड देयर इज ओनली साइलेंस नन ऑफ अस फील्स ऑकवर्ड दैट फॉर मी वुड बी द गर्ल. तुम क्यों विक्की प्लीज बोल रहे हो भाई?
So, as we know, this, the event is also a curtain raiser for our very beloved Lit Fest, which is the third chapter, and it has had a roaring success. It is a festival where we celebrate art, literature, and culture, and unlike other college festivals. So, speaking of which, I'm sure you must have been part of a college festival, and how was it to be on that side? Because this is something very non-competitive. When you talk about literature festival, we keep it as a kind of a gathering where people just want to celebrate art and culture. So, do you have any thoughts on that, these college festivals and how it's important?
No, it's always amazing. It's always amazing that one time in the year where, you know, students come together and they're given that responsibility. They're given the responsibility to create something, to hold a function, to hold this kind of a celebration. It could be of literature, art, whatever that they decide to, and then the responsibility is on their shoulder, right? You know, that is the most important thing, because when I was in my engineering college, I was the cultural head, and my festival used to be called Zodiac. Okay. but tab mujhe pata hai ki kitne papad milte hain, like the team kitne papad milte hain, firstly to get funds, then to kind of, you know, lock down the ideas, then the ideas to actually execute those ideas and then see the fruits of it. आप 10 ideas सोचते हो, execute करते हो, उसमें से 6 तो नहीं fail, like 6 fail हो जाते हैं, 4 हो पाते हैं, and then you have to think of something to replace those 6 ideas. All of that is going on, and then there's a camaraderie between the faculty and the students, which is great. That happens in during festivals, you know, which is very different from when they're attending lectures. So all of that is going on. It's a great energy, and I used to really wait for this period to come where, you know, the cultural festival is going to start. So I think this is great. Literature, art, I mean, I'm a product of that. I am nothing without the literature I read. I'm nothing without the art that I do. All the love, respect, and whatever I am having in my life is because of these two aspects. So I am totally up for anything that is celebrating these two things. So thank you so much for making me a part of it. And also, when I was doing, taking part in these cultural festivals, I know how tough it is to get actors, man. It's very tough. It's really very tough.
Thank you so much.
Haji, aajo deta hu aur actors. But haji, ye meetings humne bhi ki hai ki, and it's a very ek bahut cheap thrill hai, main share kar raha hu. Please say record mat karna, bata do. So there have been like directors and producers that when I was a cultural head of a festival and we used to go making full presentations and matlab full good boys, okay, ki sir, we're gonna get you an audience of 5,000 people. We have these sponsors, these endorsers, and it's gonna be great. The students are really waiting for you, and aap apni film ki promotion hamare festival mein kijiye. Please get the actors and ye wo. And then they used to be like, अच्छा बताइए क्या है, पर इसमें मेरे लिए क्या है, फिल्म के लिए क्या है, कौन सा इंजीनियरिंग, अच्छा ये वो फलाना. And now when they call me for discussions for the films, and then I go, and they don't remember this at all, but I remember every minute of that meeting. And then I go there now, and then they're pitching that film to me, ki Vicky, there's this film, you gotta get this kind of an audience, it's got this kind of a role. And I'm like, it's a great atmosphere. It's a great atmosphere. It's also not just for the college. Now there are students from other colleges that come, and they kind of jam together, and it's got a great energy, and more than it's also the education and things that you learn, but also these things that you get to take a part in, they also make you grow a lot. Subconsciously, it really make you grow a lot. So all the best, guys. Yes.
Thank you, your best for time. So now we're going to have the unveiling of the festival, for which we are going to have a small video, after which we are going to call the heads to be given away the letter of appointment. So first, let's, I would love you to see a small clip created by our members of Big Fest 2019. We have a line for it. Coffee lit hair. So now let me invite the Madam Principal to felicitate Vicky and also do the unveiling and hand over the letter of appointment to the head of the festival.
बताओ क्या है.